I want to talk a little bit about No Alias, because you took a big leap. I remember having these conversations with you when you were really thinking about doing this, and then you did it, and you took that leap into entrepreneurship. I want to chat with you about that. What has that experience been like? And I want to know, what has been the toughest part about being your own boss, and what's been the best thing? So,
wow. So No Alias is our, both mine and my fiance's business. It's our agency, and we catered to a multitude of more experiential, you know, marketing, digital marketing, influencer marketing, artist management. We were offering it all, right? Mm-hmm. Then 2020 came around, and I think like all other businesses, things had to pivot, and we had to step into the digital curation space. And honestly, that's where we found our strength. We found our strength to bring community together and to really become connectors of networks, mm-hmm. in spaces that never have spoken to each other before. Like it would be a popcorn company in Kentucky with a cannabis company based out of the Bay Area in California. And being able to bring those two spaces together has definitely been one of our, I don't know, what would you call it? Like one of our top priorities is connecting mm-hmm. the dots with people that are needing to expand their product, their brand, mm-hmm. The knowledge behind what they're offering, you know, as a business. And it's been great. We've also found the force behind our own friends and family that support our business, our small business. We Amazing. Have gotten a lot of referrals from media outlets, from Disney Plus, you know, to brands like PepsiCo, and even colleagues that I've worked with in the past, HBO, Red Bull. And I can't Right. be more grateful for what we've developed within our own business. And that is our internal network. Mm. But it's been hard. I will say it's been hard. And I think the strength behind No Alias is definitely my partnership with my fiance. I know this is going to sound strange, but when you're, and no, it doesn't sound strange because
not at all.
Yeah, I think there are couples out there that do work together and it works. And right. for both Mark and I, it works because we both offer two different, you know, he's an expert in production. I'm an expert in business strategy. Mm-hmm. So it's
you complement each other.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's a very yin and yang business. And I'm really proud of that because it's not really showcased enough in the world.
Right.
You know, I am a female supporter. I'm a feminist, call me whatever you want. And I am there for all women. But I also think it's important to, you know, give the flowers to the men in your life too, that are supporting you every step of the way. And Mark has definitely been that for me, especially during the pandemic, because it's scary. It was a very scary time for all of us. Mm-hmm. And I am sometimes very emotional. And as a business owner, you're not allowed to be that emotional. You're supposed to be controlled and composed at all times, since you are being paid for a service. So having mm-hmm. my partner by my side has really helped me. And the business is growing. We just did a campaign mm-hmm. with Lifewater, and it was really, really cool out in Joshua Tree. And we were able to celebrate women for Women's History Month. So we're here. Mark's taking lead, mostly because I also have responsibilities at SoundCloud to meet, mm-hmm. but No Alias is not going anywhere.